Nupur Sharma has been very patiently waiting for us from BJP headquarters. Nupur, my question to you is, I think for the first time for Madhya Pradesh and Chhattisgarh in 15 years, and Rajasthan is keeping with its trend. You know, one time it's BJP, other time it's Congress, but together it is happening after 2003. All three states, Congress has done well.
You know, first and foremost, let me just clarify, it's still too early. It's only 10 a.m. in the morning. Let's not forget what happened during Bihar elections. Picture becomes clear around 12 o'clock in the afternoon. Let's just wait and watch. Even for Gujarat, let's not even go back to Bihar in 2015. 2017, December, we all know what happened in Gujarat. It was so close and ultimately BJP actually won with a margin. So what I'm trying to say is it's still early and we know how we've performed. Let's wait and watch. Till 9 o'clock, till 4 to 9, only ballot, postal ballots were being counted. After that, the EVMs were open. Having said that, secondly, I would like to say, I actually tend to disagree, irrespective of what the results actually come about. How people vote in assembly elections is not exactly how they vote in Lok Sabha elections. Let's just go back to Delhi. We may have been the single largest party in Delhi elections in 2013. We didn't form the government in Delhi. In 2014, in those very assembly constituencies where we actually lost, we won with a margin. If you were to take the Vidhan Sabha constituencies within the Lok Sabha constituency, yet in 2015, on those very assembly constituencies we won, we lost with a huge margin. And yet again, in the MCD elections, if you were to further divide those Vidhan Sabha constituencies into wards, in MCD elections, we won. So I think there is no actual, you can say, translation from a Lok Sabha voter base to a Vidhan Sabha voter base or to an MCD voter base. The issues in elections, in assembly elections and in parliamentary elections are very different. Let's also not forget, if I were to just go by the trends as I see on the television right now, people expected us to be routed out in Rajasthan and to be swept under 50 seats. As far as these early trends show, I don't think that BJP is anywhere under 50 seats. I would still say, wait for another couple of hours before the picture is clearer.
No, Nupur, I completely agree with you. Actually, I agree with you here that in Rajasthan, people thought that it was going to be a Congress sweep. Yes, you have made a strong point there. Actually, BJP has made a recovery, you know. It's not as if BJP completely has been completely swept aside. But nonetheless, you are saying that it does not represent the national mood. But often it does. If you remember 2013 elections, barring Delhi, you did so well in Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh and Rajasthan. And the same trend was strengthened during Lok Sabha elections. You got full seats in Rajasthan. Congress barely got two Lok Sabha seats in Madhya Pradesh and you swept rest of the states. So sometimes the pattern also has a national imprint.
Yet it was a different scene altogether in Delhi assembly elections. That's exactly what I'm saying. If Aam Aadmi Party, which was a first time electoral political party in 2013, can get 28 seats, if there was, what I'm trying to say is, usually the muddas are very different. And right now I'm going to say it's too early to take a call. I'm not going to call the elections. We are confident of how we performed. However, this does go on to show that all the pollsters, I don't know if there were exit polls in the first place, because exit polls are very differently taken. People were showing trends before voting finished, before people who were actually in polling booths had come out of the polling stations by 8 or 9 p.m. So I would say let's just wait and watch how it goes. Our ground reports, our internal assessment is very different. And again, for what you just said, yes, I understand that Rajasthan polled one way and Madhya Pradesh polled one way, but Delhi polled with a very hung assembly. And the same Delhi state actually polled very differently in Lok Sabha elections, and again polled differently in assembly, then again polled differently in MCD. And the same goes for Bihar. Let's wait and watch. Although Bihar was a caste miscalculation, we are in government in Bihar today. But you know what happened. So I'm saying that, yes, the muddas are different. You cannot deny that. And right now at 10 a.m., I would still say it's still too early, given Karnataka, Gujarat, Uttar Pradesh and all these elections. We need to wait and watch.
Okay, even if you're saying that it's too early, even if you're saying that there can be a repeat of Bihar. Francois, do you have a question?
spokesperson are saying it's a big defeat for the BJP and Mr. Modi. You know, and there is overconfidence there, like in 2004 when Mr. Vajpayee was sure to win, you know, the next election, and he lost because he was overconfident. Mr. Modi is overconfident, and I think it's a big warning to the BJP for 2019, and he should, you know, he should listen to the voters. He should listen.
Nupur, do you feel that BJP is slightly overconfident this time? One of our panelists is saying François Gauthier, who has been covering India from 1971.
I don't think I made any statement, unlike other people who are actually calling the election at 10 a.m., wherein we should wait till 12 noon or at least 1 p.m. in the afternoon. I don't think it's my overconfidence. Perhaps what I'm trying to say, it is still early, and I think experienced pollsters would agree with me. That is one. Secondly, I don't think we are a party which is overconfident. I am going to take you back to the narrative that was being set before these five states went into the elections. It was simply BJP will be finished, BJP will be wiped out, BJP 50 ke bhitar samapt ho jayegi Rajasthan mein. If I were to just go by what the early trends are showing, then I'm sorry. And if I were to just believe all, if this was the actual final mandate of the people, even then BJP samapt nahi hai. Agar aap teen bari ki sarkar ki, thrice in both Chhattisgarh and Rajasthan, BJP has been in power for three terms. And agar aap uski anti-incumbency ko bhi calculate karke, if yet Congress cannot sweep an election, then are you saying that there is an anti-Narendra Modi wave?
No,
I don't read that as an anti-Narendra Modi wave. I read that as the weakness of an opposition party. One second. Secondly, on another channel, I was just asked one thing. How is the Mahagathbandhan performed? Is there a Mahagathbandhan given that BSP has actually decided to go away and contest independently away from this Mahagathbandhan farce that we get to see today? So what I'm trying to say is, I'm still going to say, I'm not calling the elections yet, I'm going to wait till noon time. But I'm going to say is that BJP puts its head down. We don't boast of moral victories. We believe in working. And Madhya Pradesh especially is a big example of a state coming out from a Bimaru state to actually a very well-developed and a robust state in all departments.
No, I think you made a strong point. You stay with me, Nupur. Dr. Anderson is with me. I think Nupur has made a strong point. You know, she's right in saying that 6 months back, people say, oh, there is a lot of agitation in Madhya Pradesh. There's a farmer agitation. Oh, there is a lot of problem in Rajasthan. Congress is 150 plus. BJP has fought back, though they might not be leading anywhere, but they have actually fought back. It just goes on to show that they have an electoral machinery which can even fight a battle which they think they might lose. Like, for example, there has not been any fight back by Congress in Mizoram. It was left to one person. So do you think that makes the difference between Congress and BJP? I'll come to you, Daniel. You make your point. Dr. Anderson?
Well, the BJP has a fantastic organization. Everybody knows that, and that has worked to its benefit. And so what they did, they also used the RSS, you know, particularly in Rajasthan. And the BJP is coming up, you know, in the seats in Rajasthan, or at least the seats I've just seen. So, no, it has been wiped out. But, you know, all said and done, though, I think the Congress made a strategic choice, which is very smart, when they decided not to name a chief minister. And before you were talking about the older and the younger generation being able to cooperate, I think that's why they are being able to cooperate. They're not competing as to who's going to be number one. The real competition is going to come after the election, when they have to choose a chief minister and they have to choose policy. So you have to get beyond kind of Modi bashing on the one hand, and you know, bashing each other. So, you know, but I think it was a strategic choice that was very smart because it kept them together.
Daniel, specifically in context of Rajasthan,
yeah,
because that's somewhere, you know, the pundits 3 months back said it's a sweep, you know, it's a gone state.
Absolutely. But if you really see, the Congress is weakest, you know, in the history of post-independent politics.
Absolutely.
You know.
Absolutely. Correct.
It has not won a single election against BJP since 2014.
Absolutely.
Not a single election.
Absolutely.
BJP does much better when it is up against Congress. Okay. By that logic, what Nupur was saying, then Congress has done very well in Gujarat. You know, by the kind of fight that a weak organization like the Congress has given to the BJP and the Prime Minister's home turf. So, you know, I really think that this, you know, of course, BJP,
I think Daniel,
it should have won that election.
Yes,
for the machinery that BJP is.
Okay.
I'm expecting a win.
Okay. Nupur, you wanted to make a point?
Can I just come in?
Sure, come.
Yeah, just please. For Gujarat. Was it Gujarat? Was Gujarat a case where Congress was going alone? See, Congress is a party today which needs outsider help. There was a Baisakhi, a trioka of caste-based hatred, hate-filled politics that worked for them in Gujarat. And it wasn't Congress's win. If Congress was going alone, in spite of the fact that not 22 but 27 years of anti-incumbency against BJP, if in Gujarat Congress was going alone, I would very confidently say that Congress single digit pe simmer jati. But we all know what happened before the elections. The kind of statements and the kind of televised statements, mind you, that continue to be made by that hate-filled trioka Baisakhi supporters of Congress party, that they continue to make on television today. We all know what went behind Congress's entire game plan. From getting, financial support from SDPI, which is nothing but PFI, which PFI is considered to be a very, almost like a resurrected SIMI, banned SIMI organization. If you're getting financial help from PFI, SDPI to help Congress-supported netas and leaders in Gujarat, then you know what kind of hatred and what kind of, objectives went behind Gujarat elections.
I think, Daniel, you wanted to make a point to Nupur. You know, Nupur had made a point on PFI.
Yeah.
You wanted to make a point?
No, Nupur.
Yeah, make a point.
I just wanted to say one thing, that, you know, the Congress doesn't have the machinery, nor the cadre, nor the leader, nor the money, nor the power in the states or in the center to give a tough fight to BJP. Yet, it is looking that the Congress is making a serious dent in the states, perhaps coming to power. How do you really assess that? Is it a public perception that has gone against the BJP?
You're not factoring in anti-incumbency. You may have compared the well-oiled machinery of political machinery and electoral machinery of Congress and BJP. You have to factor in the anti-incumbency. Anti-incumbency was also a factor in Gujarat elections. And you can't deny that. We had to really work really hard in Gujarat, and we are a party which believes in working
the
hard.
Prime Minister,
and that's exactly
turned
what we did in these states as well. But again,
you're absolutely right. You're absolutely right with the anti-incumbency, particularly in Chhattisgarh and in Madhya Pradesh, the 15-year anti-incumbency. But the Prime Minister turned that anti-incumbency in Gujarat. Why is it that the Prime Minister's personal capital could not turn this anti-incumbency into pro-incumbency? We've also seen pro-incumbency governments in the last 15 years.
Don't you think with that statement you've just called the election already?
No, I'm not calling. I'm just saying the trends are suggesting.
Of course you did. Abhi, see, the results are not out. You've just actually passed a word that his charm did not work. I'm going to say wait and watch. I was another channel. In the first channel at 9 o'clock, Chhattisgarh was 24 seats for BJP and 56 odd seats for Congress. When I went to the other channel at 9:30, BJP went on to 35 seats. And I'm sorry, it might have changed even now and may change another 1 hour.
Absolutely.
I'm going to take you back to Bihar. It's too early to take a call. Okay. It's only been 2 hours. Let's wait and watch.
Nupur, last question for you from Dr. Walter Anderson.
Actually, the point is, I think, you know, you have a Congress which has been relatively weak, and I'm not sure it's Congress as an organization that is behind this strength or Rahul, but there's anger in the population. The farmers are angry, Dalits are angry, you know, groups that, you know, in the past would be, you know, some groups relied upon in voting for the BJP. So what is the BJP doing to address these issues? Because whatever the outcome, there's no doubt there's farmer discontent. There's no doubt that many Dalits are unhappy. So what is the BJP plan to do to address these voters, particularly before the 2019 general election? I mean, they have to. I mean, it's clear. Whatever the outcome is at the end of the day,
see,
that you mentioned.
Mr. Anderson, we were actually dealing with these very things when we came into power in 2014 as well. You need to understand that these are not first-time problems that any incumbent political party, especially in government, is facing. The fact is, that when you speak about farmers, there are many policies which have been brought about by the government in center, and more so for a state government like Madhya Pradesh, which has seen an entire turnaround as far as agriculture is concerned. The reality is that India is a huge country. When a policy is made at the center, for it to reach out to the last person standing in the queue, it takes some time. A very small example I'm going to take. While there are many irrigation policy and MSP policies and soil health card policies and seed policies and so on and so forth, and waiver of loan policies, the reality is that for example, in Modi Care, what we famously call Modi Care, has been denied in three states where BJP is not in power in the state government. So you need to understand that we also have bottlenecks when it comes from when it comes to trickling down from the center to the state and eventually to the last person standing in the queue. It will take time. We've only been in power for 4.5 years, yet the rural population trusts our Prime Minister to another level. The faith that the people of India repose in him is actually incomparable. And I think he's one person who works, he's one person who makes his ministers work, and that's what we bank upon. We put our head down and we work with our folded hands.
Thank you, Nupur. Thank you so much for joining me from BJP headquarters. Thank you so much.